the biggest name in contemporary blues is coming to Bluesville with his own weekly show.
Hi, I'm Joe Bonamassa. Join me for an hour of music from my personal collection on my new show, Different Shades of Blue.
Different Shades of Blue.
It debuts Monday, 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific.
Right here in B.B. King's Bluesville.
This is Joe Bonamassa right here on SiriusXM Bluesville, and this is my show, Different Shades of Blue. You know, one of the things that I was most proud of in my career was a gig we did at Red Rocks in 2014, and we paid tribute to the great Muddy Waters and the great Howlin' Wolf. And when my producer, Kevin Shirley, came to me with the idea, I said, oh my God, those are two of the most iconic blues singers ever to decide to sing the blues. I mean, Howlin' Wolf especially was just such a monstrous voice. I couldn't imagine covering Howlin' Wolf songs, you know, especially at Red Rocks in front of 10,000 people. And I kind of mustered up the courage to do it, and I really embraced it and got myself into this this headspace of like not trying to be those guys, but just doing my own versions. And we rehearsed for 2 days, and we basically, you know, did two warm-up shows and this gig that we recorded for, a DVD, by the way, which you can purchase at jbonamassa.com. Thank you for the plug. You can see it on the DVD. It's like, it's just one of the most joyous nights of music that I've ever experienced. And I think to this day, it's my best performance ever. So I'm going to play a little Howlin' Wolf for you right now. This is called Howlin' for My Darling, the great Howlin' Wolf, right here on SiriusXM Bluesville. That was Government Mule with a song called Railroad Boy from an album By a Thread. That is one of my favorite songs that Warren has ever written. It's an old poem, he told me, that he put music to. And it's kind of like what I did with a song called The Ballad of John Henry. It was an old song, poem, myth that I kind of put new music to, and it turned out to be one of my biggest songs. But you know, I just did a charity event for Warren Haynes and his wife Stephanie called the Christmas Jam, and we had such a blast. And what I always realized about Warren was how talented of a guitar player, musician, and a writer. But on that night, I just watched him sing, and you realize he's like one of the greatest singers, you know, singing today. I mean, he's just such a soulful, gigantic voice that comes out of him. And he's always been like that. And he's just one of those kind of artists that you just go, man, save some talent for the rest of us. With a song and a band that is criminally underrated and one of my favorite bands. And if you read interviews, listen to people talk, you know, that were there in the 60s in London, they always name check this band, Free. And I asked the question to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, why aren't they in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Why isn't Paul Rodgers, Paul Kossoff, Andy Frazier, and Simon Kirk inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame? Because, you know, that song, All Right Now, is the most played rock and roll song in the history of rock and roll radio. Here's a song by them called I'll Be Creepin'. Thank you very much for listening. This is Joe Bonamassa with Different Shades of Blue, right here on SiriusXM. I heard an old Bonnie Raitt song called Give It Up or Let It Go from the album of the same title. Now, Bonnie, to me, is one of the most underrated, unappreciated guitarists and blues singers of all time. We all know her for her big hits that she had in the 80s. The record Nick of Time just produced classic song after classic song. But if you go back and dig into Bonnie's catalog, she was a stone-cold, wicked blues singer. She is a stone-cold, wicked blues singer and a great, great guitar player. She doesn't get mentioned enough with the great guitar players. To me, I put her up there right with Lowell George, both vocally and guitar-wise. Hey everybody, Joe Bonamassa here with some more blues for you this week. We're going to start off with a
guy who really influenced me when I was a kid. His name is Albert Collins. And I got to sit in with him when I was 13 years old. And he was a wonderful gentleman, a scholar of the blues, and one of the most ruthless competitors on stage. So I'd like to start off the show with a little tribute to my friend and yours, Mr. Albert Collins. The song is called Iceman, live in concert. That was B.B. King and Bobby Bland with a song called Don't Cry No More from their album Live Together. I know the announcer on that record when you first put it on says live for the very first time in person. Well, you know, Bobby actually worked for B.B. King on the road. I think he helped B.B. out on the road. I think he was a bus driver. He helped kind of tour manage. And B.B. King really encouraged him to be a singer and an artist himself. So there wouldn't be a Bobby Blue Bland if it wasn't for the fastidious encouragement of Mr. B.B. King. So it always gets me when the announcer comes on in that record and says, you know, live together for the very first time. Well, B.B. and Bobby knew each other for many years before that. But again, one of the great live recordings of those two wonderfully legendary blues musicians. You know, one of the things that I really do enjoy about the Keeping the Blues Alive Foundation and the Spotlight is the fact that when I was a kid, discovery of music and instruments and just records was so vital to my education and my development as a human being. You know, if you ask my girlfriend, I haven't changed since I've been like 6 years old, all because I still have this youthful enthusiasm for the music. And I think if we give away some saxophone reeds or guitar strings or guitars, or if we play some songs on this show that you guys really enjoy, to me, that takes me back to my childhood in that age of discovery. And I hope I never lose that kind of childhood, you know, exuberance for the music. Because after that, what's left for me, ladies and gentlemen? I can't really hold a real job. Up next, I have one of my favorite artists that has come out in the last 15 years. His name is Marcus King, and he's from North Carolina. He's probably one of the most talented individuals to pick up a guitar and sing in the last 20 years. Absolutely blows me away with his natural instincts, one of the best. Marcus King, a song called Homesick from his album Carolina Confessions. You may recognize that song from the Carlos Santana version of it, but that was Fleetwood Mac doing Black Magic Woman, written by the great Peter Green. And one of the things that I wanted to talk about, because you just heard Gary Moore before that, was Peter Green's iconic 1959 Les Paul was also owned by Gary Moore, who played that on the track Oh Pretty Woman. So you're hearing the same guitar, but with two different players. And that's one of the great things about guitar collecting and guitar playing in general, is that you can hand someone your instrument and they sound like themselves. The word is tactile.